Hey, what's up everybody? It's me, Tony. So today I'm going to be reviewing the book, The Conquest of Happiness by Bertrand Russell, so that you can live a happier, healthier life. I'll be giving you Bertrand's main keys to happiness and his main keys to unhappiness, so that you can do more of what works and less of what doesn't work, so that your life will improve. First, Bertrand says that the major cause of unhappiness is when people have too much of an occupation with themselves. And what I mean by this is, or what he means by this is, energy that could be going outwards constructively is going inwards destructively. Instead of people going out and using their energy to work or to play or to do things that they enjoy, what they're doing is they're sitting around thinking that their life should be better, or focusing too much on things that aren't working, or focusing on the negativity within themselves, telling themselves that they're sinners or they're bad or they're not good enough. And so they're essentially doing too much introspection of a negative type. So Bertrand says one of the major causes of all unhappiness is too much of an occupation with oneself. So what you need to do is, if you're feeling unhappy, is take that energy that's going inwards destructively and let it go out outwards constructively. Find some hobbies, find a cause that you believe in, go and volunteer. Volunteering, by the way, is one of the best ways to make you happier, because you'll be using a lot of your energy to uplift somebody else, and it'll give you a great feeling of self-esteem, self-approval, and self-respect. Another major cause of unhappiness is early childhood beliefs and experiences. For instance, let's say we have a kid that wants to go out and play, and when he was younger, his mother would stifle that urge by telling him he has to stay inside because she was worried that something would happen to him. Now he's an adult, and he wants to go out and do stuff in the world, but there's this inner critical voice that keeps stopping him from doing what he wants to do. So if you're an adult and you want to go do things, but you feel like there's something internally stopping you, use your reason and tell yourself, hey, this is what I want to do now, and I'm going to go do it. And if some objections come up, whatever the objection is, just write out its positive opposite. So if you say, oh, I might not have enough money to do whatever you want to do, say, hey, write out, you know, I can save enough money to go do it. There's always a way to do what it is that you want to do. Another reason a lot of people are unhappy is because of early childhood beliefs that they received. For instance, Bertrand has a whole chapter on the subject of sin. And he talks about how people want to do all this stuff, but they've been told that they have to be like saints or totally perfect, otherwise they're sinning. So you're an adult now. You were taught this stuff as little kids. But you're an adult, so use your God-given reason to examine your beliefs. Any ideas that are harming you that don't serve, throw those out. In fact, some of the ideas we have are so silly. Some ideas that we think are sinful, and other, they're just cultural ideas or taboos. In other cultures, they're okay. So look at your ideas, look at your belief systems, and those ideas and beliefs that don't serve, throw them out. Again, you can write out any negative idea you have about yourself, and take it and replace it with its positive opposite, and start to affirm the new positive idea to yourself, and eventually that will become your reality and that old negative idea will fall off. Another major cause of people's unhappiness is their moods. There's a law of rhythm. There's times you're going to feel totally up, and there's going to be times that you feel totally down. Just remember that truth at either of those states is relative. When you're in a good mood, the world is going to feel sunny and bright and optimistic. And when you're in a bad mood, it might feel dark and cloudy and gloomy. But remember that when you're in a negative mood, that's not the truth. That's just how things are appearing to you. So realize, like, hey, I'm just in a negative state. In fact, this is a great way to use the law of rhythm in your favor. Realize, hey, I'm just in a negative state. I'm going to go do something constructive, like go walk in nature. Or call a friend and have that friend. This is what my friends and I do. If one of us is feeling down, we call the other one, and the other one boosts that other one up and tells them how great they are and how good they are, and that instantly pops that person back into a positive rhythm. So go do something constructive with your energy when you're in that low mood to get yourself back into a high mood. Another major cause of unhappiness is fatigue. Some people just feel run down or tired. And Bertrand says that one of the major causes of fatigue, or the major cause to him, of fatigue is worry. People are spending too much time worrying about something that really is not of value. He said instead, you should do constructive thinking. Write out, what can I do about this problem? And set aside a specific amount of time to write out whatever ideas, even if they seem like they might not work, it's better to write out some type of constructive plan and allow your subconscious to really absorb that plan and go to work on it, and then put it aside, like get that thing off and out of your mind, than to sit around all day worrying about it. So get rid of worry, replace it with hope. If there's a problem that's bothering you, take some time, write out what is the problem, write out your solution to it, sit and think about it for a little bit, and then go about your day. Get that worry out of your head and get yourself into action. A major cause of unhappiness for a lot of people is a loss of income. He said most pessimists are usually just people who lost their income or their income is not where they want it to be. And so instead of looking for opportunities, they're focusing on the negative. So if that happens to be you, if you've lost some income or your stature isn't where it once was, realize that you can take that energy and build yourself back up. It's never too late. Take that energy that's going inwards destructively and put it outwards constructively and transform your life. Environment. This is a huge cause of unhappiness for a lot of people. If you're living in an environment that's not supportive, move. Go somewhere else. You're not obligated to be around people that make you unhappy. So move yourself to an environment of people who are like-minded, so you'll feel supported, uplifted, and appreciated, and as a result, you'll feel happier. And lastly, Bertrand talks about fear. A lot of people are just afraid, and mostly they're afraid of what other people think about them. But in reality, most people aren't thinking about you. And if they are thinking about you, they're thinking about what you're thinking about them. So put those ideas of the fear of public opinion out of your mind. Focus on what you do best, on what you want to do. And in fact, people will look at you with awe and appreciation and admiration for the good that you're doing. I almost forgot one thing. Envy. A lot of people are envious of what other people had. They're comparing themselves to others and making themselves feel worse. If you're going to use, by the way, that's called the law of relativity. If you're going to use it in your favor. Compare yourself to somebody worse off and you'll instead feel better. And Bertrand talks about, this is actually I think is great, use that energy of envy. You can use it constructively, and to do so, use it as admiration. See what someone else has and admire them for their possessions or their qualities of character, and strive to develop those qualities of character, or strive to go out and get what they have. Not what they have actually, but something similar. So see what they have and admire them for it, and build up within yourself those qualities, or go out into the world and get what they have, and your self-esteem will build. So instead of envy, use admiration to make yourself better. All right, now I'm going to be focusing on some of the major causes of happiness. And one of the first causes of happiness that Bertrand says are extracurricular activities. Find yourself a cause or some hobbies or activities that allow you to take your energy and expend it outward. For instance, you can go volunteer at your local church. Volunteering is a great way to build your self-esteem and to really make a difference in your community and the world. You could also go and volunteer at some cause, such as a political organization that you believe in, and that'll really get your juices flowing and put your energy outwards. You could also take up some hobbies. What do you like to do? For instance, I like to kickbox, I like to read books, I like to go to workshops. I have all these hobbies outside of my work that allow me to take my mind off work and channel my energy into things that I enjoy. Not that I don't enjoy my work, but it allows me a break from work-related thinking and activities to go relax and do stuff that I enjoy just for the sake of pure enjoyment. Another major cause of happiness is savoring the moment. We're all here for a finite time. Nobody's gonna live forever. And when you realize that concept, it allows you to enjoy every moment. You'll develop a real appreciation for each and every activity that you do. Instead of seeing things as a means to an end, people and things will become a means unto themselves, and you'll do things for the simple act of doing them. This reminds me of when I go to restaurants. This isn't quite the same thing, but it'll make your lunches and dinners much better. When I go to restaurants, I set the bar really low as to the level of the meal, meaning I don't expect much from the places that I go to. I pick places that I like, but then I don't expect much from them. My simple belief is, hey, I didn't cook it, so I'm gonna enjoy it. And as a result, I'm almost always happy with the meals that I get. So savor the moments, and you can also set a low bar. Don't expect too much, and it'll make your life really easy. I expect a lot from people, not from restaurants. And as a result, it'll make your life really easy, and you'll be much happier. Another major cause of happiness is work. Find something that you love to do. Do something that you enjoy. You're gonna spend maybe a third of your life, 40 hours a week at work, so find something that makes you come alive. If you can't find it in your work, at least find it in your extracurricular activities. For instance, not everybody can leave their work, or you can develop a side hustle that brings you a lot of joy. But if you can, do work that you enjoy. Now I'm gonna give you the secret to happiness, and I'm gonna read it directly from the book. And Bertrand says, the secret of happiness is this: let your interest be as wide as possible, and let your reactions to the things and persons that interest you be as far as possible friendly rather than hostile. I'll read it again. He said, let your interest be as wide as possible, and let your reactions to the things and persons that interest you be as far as possible friendly rather than hostile. The person who has a wide variety of interests that make him happy, a wide variety of sources of happiness, should be much better off than the person that only has one source of happiness. Because if that person's source is cut off, for instance, let's say we have a man who loves running, and he's been running all his life, and let's say he falls one day and he's not able to run anymore, his one source of happiness will be cut off. However, if he had numerous sources of happiness, he'd still be able to be healthy, to be happy, and as a result, he'd be able to channel that energy into those other avenues. So develop numerous sources of happiness. And as far as, being as friendly as possible to people, that's common sense. When you see people that you like, even people you don't like, allow yourself to be as friendly as possible. Think good thoughts towards others. Greet people enthusiastically. If somebody brings you something negative, look for the good in it. And so reassure that person of the good, and as a result, you'll feel better and they'll feel better. That's it. That's my review of The Conquest of Happiness. Apply these rules in your life and you'll be happier and healthier. I'm also going to be reviewing the books, the seminars, and the workshops that I go to, along with any other audiobooks and any other type of material I come across. If there's something you want me to review, leave me a comment down below and I'll do my best to get to it.